click this video, you want to know how you can keep your vagina healthy. Well, guess what? I know how. I got some tips for you bitches. Is 7 ways to keep your vagina healthy. Now, I'm no doctor, I'm no specialist, but I do know how to keep my vagina healthy, okay? Okay. So I'm not gonna take too much of y'all's time, let's get into it. The first way to keep your vagina healthy is to use gentle soaps. By gentle, I mean not Victoria's Secret, not Bath and Body Works. Do not put that crap in your vagina. If it has a scent in it, do not put it in your vagina. Clear. Just is that clear? If it has a scent, do not put it in your vagina. Okay. Soaps that you can use. You can use Dove Unscented Beauty Bar. That works really good. You can use Baby Wash, like Johnson & Johnson. That's good. It's for babies. Can't get no safer than that if it's for a baby. You can also use regular feminine washes, your Summer's Eve, what's the other brand? It's another brand that I don't know off the top of my head, but whatever. Y'all will know when y'all see it in the store. Vagisil, right? Yeah, Vagisil, that's it. Summer's Eve and Vagisil, y'all can use those. They are gentle washes. Also, another thing. You do not technically need to wash your vagina out with soap because it's a natural cleaner. And when I say wash it with soap, I mean the inside of the lips and the around your clitoral area. Do not put this soap inside y'all vagina. I think y'all should know that because baby girl, you gotta mess it up and it's gonna burn. It's gonna burn. Yeah, so don't do that. So only like on the inside of the lip flaps, I don't know if this is a good visual, but on the inside of the lip flaps, you know, you can with your hands. I don't know if y'all want to use a towel. That's weird. But with your hands on the inside of the lips, around there, do not go in the hole. Stay clear of the hole. But you can just use water and occasionally use soap. It'll keep you clean. That's all you need. Too much can be bad, not enough can be bad. You gotta find your perfect balance. You gotta figure out how your vagina works, okay? Okay. I think y'all see where I'm going with these ways to keep it clean. I'm not about to play with y'all. I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. You should know this by now. And if you don't, welcome. I'm here to educate you, okay? Okay. The second tip is to use lukewarm water. You do not want to rinse your vagina out with hot water. One, hot water, hotness, high temperatures breed bacteria. And you don't want no more extra bacteria in your vagina than the bacteria that you need. You catching it? So use lukewarm water. That's simple. I don't think I have to explain that much more. Use lukewarm water. Tip number 3 is, when you're on your menstrual cycle, you need to change your tampons and pads regularly. And when I say by regularly, I mean like you have the choice of changing it every time you go to the bathroom. Because some people we don't really go to the bathroom that often. If you're habitual peer, like you pee every hour, maybe every hour. I mean, every time you pee is not a good choice for you. So you can do maybe 3 to 4 hours. Change your tampon every 3 to 4 hours, because if you do not, one, it can start to smell. Let me just say this right now. Period blood should not smell, okay? If your period blood smells, maybe you have an underlying problem that you need to go to the gynecologist about. But if you have a pad on too long, it can begin to smell. But the reason you don't want to have them in too long is because it'll breed bacteria, which can cause yeast infections, bacterial vaginosis and all this other stuff that you don't want. So change your pad and your tampon regularly. I suggest maybe every 3 to 4 hours or every time that you go to the bathroom. Or if you just anal about it, hell, change it whenever you feel like it, but it has to be, you have to do it often, okay? Change that thing. It's already uncomfortable enough, especially if you wear pads. It's like you're sitting on a diaper. You don't want that mess on your ass, do you? You can't want that on that ass. You can't want that on that ass. So just change it, and then you're going to see that it helps the vaginal flora. It keeps your cooter clean. Keep the cooter clean, okay? Change the pad. The fourth thing that you need to know to keep your vagina healthy is you need to know the difference between a yeast infection and bacterial vaginosis. Bacterial vaginosis is also known as BV. And if you don't know what BV is, maybe you've never had BV. Just to clear this up, BV is not a sexually transmitted infection. No, it's not at all. It can come from having too much of bad bacteria in vagina or not having enough bacteria in vagina. It comes from just being unclean or being too clean. It comes from messing with your genitals, when you have dirty hands and dirty fingers, when you're having encounters with a sexual partner, if their mouth isn't clean, if their hands aren't clean, you can get bacterial vaginosis. That simple. It can literally, anything can throw off your vaginal flora, which is like the pH of your vagina. So you got to be real technical with it. Like, you really got to be OC about it. OC? OD. Is it OCD? What is it? Compulsive, obsessive, compulsive disorder? OCD. You got to be a little OCD when it comes to your cooter. It's your most prized possession, ladies. You hear me? Your most prized possession. But back to the educational part. Okay, I got it on my iPad. So, you have to know the difference between a yeast infection and BV. Discharge for a yeast infection will be maybe thick and white and look like cottage cheese. While on the other hand, BV, your discharge will be thin, sometimes maybe clear, even gray or yellowish. The key difference between a yeast infection and BV is a yeast infection will itch. You're gonna feel like you wanna scratch your damn vagina off. You're gonna wanna scratch it all out. Just snatch it out. And then BV, the shit is gonna reek. It's gonna smell so motherfucking bad. You're gonna feel like you're in the deep blue sea, okay? That's how you gonna know. Is it itchy or do it stink? Now here, if you have a yeast infection, you can get over-the-counter medicines to clear it up, a cream or something like that. But BV, honey, you have to actually go to the doctor and they're gonna give you something for it. You can't, it's just, the smell just not gonna go away. It don't matter how much soap, how much home remedies you use, you use a yeast infection cream ain't gonna cure it. You have to go to the doctor and they're gonna give you an antibiotic for it, pretty much. And I'm gonna say this again, it is not a sexually transmitted disease, people. Get it together. You should know this by now, but if you don't, I'm here to educate you, okay? Okay, let's keep it moving. Number five, the fifth thing is you gotta watch what you eat. I would say it's good to maybe drink a lot of water, don't drink too many pops, too much sugary drinks, don't eat too much candy, not too many salty foods like chips and all that. You wanna stay away from that. Fruits and vegetables are the best way to go. They're natural sweeteners, all this stuff. You get your nutrition, all that good stuff. And cranberry juice helps too. Like, cranberry juice helps with UTIs and all this stuff, just cleaning out the toxins in your urine and stuff like that. So you want to drink water, eat fruits and vegetables, stay away from sugars, and stay away from high sodium products. That simple. The sixth thing is wash your hands before touching your private parts. Okay, be very, very, very particular with your vagina. always wash your hands whenever you want to mess with it, touch with it, whatever you're doing. Have your partner wash their hands as well when they want to touch you, okay? All type of bacteria, debris, dirt, all that type of stuff be under people's nails. And y'all know y'all boyfriends is dirty. Y'all know they dirty. They don't wash their hands. They don't keep their fingernails clipped. And they want to go and touching you and all this stuff. Putting all that stuff up in them. No, baby boy. You have to be clean if you want to deal with me. Okay? Okay. Let's keep it moving. That's all I'm going to say on that. Be real, like, be real stuck up. Like, you can't touch me. Did you wash your hands? No. Like, if they want to hit them with that, oh no, boy, did you wash your hands? You're not touching me if you wash your hands. I don't know where your hands been. Y'all want to be outside all day playing ball, playing a game, at the mall, doing this, in class, move up the bam, all that. Don't wash your hands not one time. Don't wash your hands not one time today. And then you want to come home and get to touching on people. Man, wash your motherfucking hands. Wash that ass too, because some of y'all niggas is dirty and y'all don't be taking showers. Y'all don't be washing up, so go and wash that ass too. And you knock it all at once. You come home, get in the shower, wash your hands, wash that ass. It did cool. It's game time. But no, ladies, when I tell you, be stuck up with your cooter. Don't be down. If they you doing too much, they ain't the one, sus. They ain't the one. If they don't care about the health of your vagina, they shouldn't be getting none. That's all I gotta say. And then the very last thing, and this is the seventh one, number seven. The seventh thing is know your own body. If you have to self-examine, know what it looked like, know how it feels on a regular basis. It's good to know these things because once you know how your vagina acts on a daily basis, when something is thrown off, you will know. You'll be like, ooh, that ain't right. Ooh, that ain't right. Oh, it don't smell like that. Oh, my discharge doesn't look like that. Or something not feeling right today. Just know your body. Take a mirror, look inside. Oh, that wasn't that the other day. Oh, that looks about right. Oh, I'm not used to seeing that. Just know what it looked like. Be particular about your vagina. That's what we're going to call it. Vagina. Be very particular about it, ladies, because it's nothing to play with. You don't want to walk around with a sick cooter. Like, that's not cute. You don't want to walk around with a little smell. You don't want to walk around being itchy, scratchy, uncomfortable. You just don't want to do it. So the best way to do it is to know your body. And that's how I'm going to conclude this video. I don't have anything else to say. There's seven ways to keep your vagina healthy. I hope you learned something. I hope you were entertained. I hope you subscribe. I hope you like. And I hope you comment. And that's all I got to say. Bye.